busy Monday morning out there. Well, this morning there are signs of continuing tension between the U.S. government and BP execs. This comes amid new concerns that there could be a leak in the well, which has been successfully capped off for 3 days.
At the same time, officials say the oil giant is not complying with Washington's demands for more monitoring. It's expected that the government will allow testing to proceed in 24-hour increments, but will also require more analysis. Now, as the struggle continues to keep the oil from gushing again, another battle begins this week in Tallahassee.
This one being drawn off our shores and about drilling. Tori Dunnan now live in the Tech Center with more on how one local lawmaker will participate today. Tori.
Paul, Felicia, Governor Charlie Crist called for this special session to start this week. The governor is outspoken when it comes to a possible ban on offshore oil drilling in Florida's waters. He's looking to draft an amendment to the state's constitution. We actually talked with a state representative who's on his way to the state capitol. Mark Pafford represents District 88. His colleagues will debate banning oil drilling 10 miles off the coast of Florida. He's driving to Tallahassee for a special session, which will be taking place on Tuesday. And Pafford says a lot is at stake, especially for the state of Florida when it comes to drilling off the coast. Leaders have been keeping a close eye on this environmental disaster since the beginning, and it's a disaster that's affecting both the state's environment and economy. Pafford says there's been talk that this special session will begin and end with the strike of the gavel, and it's possible the bill won't even be heard.
If it gets heard, I think we will ban offshore drilling 10 miles off the coast of Florida, which in my view is something to have in the Constitution. I think, you know, Florida is very unique in the nation, and tourism, our beaches, are our gem.
Pafford tells us there are many people in the House who voted for oil drilling. They don't want to look like they're flip-flopping before the primaries in August or the general election in November. So Felicia and Paul, he says that politics are really playing a role in this.
Tori, I can imagine. Now, if an amendment does get approved, what happens next?
Felicia, we've learned that that amendment will have to be drafted by the beginning of August, and then it goes on the ballot in November, and then at that point, it requires voter approval. Felicia, Paul?
All right, Tori Dunn reporting live in the newsroom.